In the budget framework paper 2023-2024, the budget ceiling of the Minister of Tourism and Antiquities was cut to less than half, from 195 billion shillings in the current financial year to 89.29 billion shillings in 2023-2024 financial year budget. Cuts had mostly affected the Uganda Tourism Board budget, which was reduced from 26.45 billion shillings to 4.3 billion shillings. Uganda Wildlife Education Center's budget was trimmed from 9.5 billion shillings to 1.9 billion shillings in 2023-2024. Uganda Wildlife Authority was allocated only 21.3 billion shillings from 40 billion shillings.
The first time we appeared before our committee, we had challenges when our budgets had been cut fundamentally. But now the budget was reinstated with a small bit of increment. So I want to thank government for the consideration.
Appearing before the Parliamentary Committee of Trade and Tourism, the Minister of State for Tourism, Martin Mogara, revealed the news on the reinstatement. Reinstatement of cuts has come with an additional 10 billion shillings for the development budget, which is aimed at developing a pier at the source of the River Nile.
And now we are going to develop a pier at the source of the Nile. You're going to see some good developments at the source of the Nile, which we believe is going to be one of the key products we shall be marketing as a country, because it's the source of the longest river in the world. So it's been good. We are going to start the process up and moving. We had already done the feasibility studies.
Despite a budget increase, the budgetary allocation for the Minister of Tourism is still low compared to the National Development Plan 3 figures, which provide for over 600 billion shillings. Mogara recognizes the deficit, but is hopeful that next time this will be improved.
But we want to thank them for this one, for the reinstatement and the little additional funding to the sector. And for us, we shall use it to bring results. As you saw, even with the funding that we had this financial year, the numbers we had of the people, of the visitations to the parks and the visitations to Uganda Wildlife Education Center, surpassed all the numbers we've ever gotten from the time we were founded as a country.
Meanwhile, the Minister of Tourism has assured the public that the recent passed anti-homosexuality bill will not affect the tourism industry. Mogara noted that some Arab countries who have similar legislations are thriving in the tourism industry.
Moving slowly because of the funding issues, now we are going to address and move much faster. And I believe that's one of the facilities we shall be looking at. So there are so many across the country. This gives us a lot of vigor to, first of all, to achieve the end line of these projects.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.